Good morning, students. I am Dhananjay Kumar Singh, science teacher in Vidyapati Public School, UK. In previous, we discussed about charge and its property. Today, we discuss about electric field. Electric field is very important term in electricity. Generally, electric field, we think that the area surrounding a charge. But electric field contains two terms inside it, electric field and electric field strength. Generally, electric field means the area surrounding a charge within which other test charge feel force of attraction or repulsion. So electric field is area. On the other hand, electric field strength, the force experienced by a test positive unit charge in electric field is called electric field strength. So we can write here electric field strength equal to electric field strength. GTH. E equal to force by amount of charge. Amount of charge. Suppose that we place a Q charge and that charge feels experience a force F, then you can write here E equal to F by Q. We get here F equal to QE. F equal to QE. This is the electric field strength. It is a vector quantity. It follows the rule of superposition of two electric fields. General formula for electric field at a point due to a charge is the electric field at a distance r from a charge Q is given by E equal to KQ by R square. You can write here capital R. It is KQ by R square, where K is a constant. Whose value is equal to 9 into 10 to the power 9. We can derive the unit of K by Coulomb's law of force. K, Q1, Q2 by R square. From here, we can easily obtain the unit of K. It is then K will be F R square by Coulomb square. F R square by Coulomb square. It comes out to be Newton meter square divided by Coulomb square. coulomb square. It means newton meter square per coulomb square. This expression is for find the electric field at a distance r from a charge q equal to kq by r square, where k is constant whose value equal to 9 into 10 power 9 newton meter square divided by coulomb square. In next section we discuss Coulomb's law of force. Very important, Coulomb's law of force. Between two charges, it is given by Coulomb. First law is the force of attraction or repulsion. The force of attraction or repulsion between two charges Q1 and Q2 is directly proportional to product of charge. It means F proportional to Q1 into Q2. This is the first law. The force of attraction or repulsion between two charges Q1 and Q2 is directly proportional to product of the charge. If this is the sign of proportional, this is the directly proportional of force. It means Q1 into Q2. And second law is inversely proportional to a square of distance between the charge, a square of distance between the charge. So we can write here F inversely proportional to 1 by R square. F is directly proportional to Q1 into Q2. It means product of charge. And second law is inversely proportional to a square of distance between the charge. It means F inversely proportional to 1 by R square. If we combine these two laws, we get combining 1 and 2, we get F proportional to Q1 into Q2 by R square. When combining these two laws, we get here A proportional to Q1 and Q2 by R squared. And you know that when sign of proportionality is removed, a constant appears. It means A equal to K, Q1, Q2 by R squared. This is the Coulomb's law. And whole physics, electricity, is based on Coulomb's law, very important in deriving every formula like potential. Today, Coulomb's law, where K equal to 9 to the 10th power 9, Newton, we derive here, F equal to K, you can write here, K equal to F R square, it means Newton meter square divided by Coulomb square. Its other value is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Both are equivalent. So you must revise these topics for better grasp on subject matter. In next class, we study different topics.